That's enough. My tire. Nobody else is buying tires in my car but me. So.
Hello, I'm your wife.
Stop whining already, goddammit. We have to put a fucking duct tape on Willie.
Alright guys, I'm not fully set up yet, but I had to show this to you. Now that part that you saw, the car burning out, no, that's not a different video. I edited it correctly. That is at this wedding. This is like a Jeff Foxworthy wedding. They pulled in on a freaking four-wheeler, the bride and groom. They've been riding through town on a four-wheeler. So, say no more. Here we are. This is where we're at. This is the community center in Hawkins. Hawkins is a town of about 70 people. This is the pavilion that I get. Okay, so we got a separate pavilion for the dance floor. Here's some of the kids that are going to be dancing tonight. Not fully done setting up, but that's how I'm running it. Hopefully we do a good job with sound. I think it'll be fine. And that's where they're eating over there, right? Is everyone over there eating in that one? Cheering away?
No, I'm Rachel.
So you're Rachel, and that's the car that did the burnout.
This is Billy. I'm Billy.
This is the limo that they got. Well, it's not really a limo. It is a hot rod bus.
Now what are you doing?
Taking some video. And where's the four-wheeler? I can't see the four-wheeler.
They're not here anymore.
No, they took the four-wheelers back? Okay. So, I'm going to continue setting up. And we're going to tape some more when we're playing some music, and you guys are going to be dancing, right?
Yeah!
Yeah. All right. You like dancing. Just sound checking and testing the lights. It'll work. All right. How is everything going so far? Well, we really haven't even done a grand march yet because people keep on leaving that are part of the wedding party. They're really drunk, all of them. And so I just said, well, let's just play something because we were supposed to do a grand march like 10 minutes ago. Let's just start so people, you know, come over to this room. Because since they have two buildings, it's going to be hard to keep everybody in one building that has absolutely no seating. So we'll see how it goes. I think it's going to be fun, but I think we're going to have people that are passing out pretty early. So, check it in a while. Fog really makes the light show look bigger than it is. A little trick. Since I only brought one sub, there really isn't a whole lot of power for the way this room is to really thump monstrously. So when they want me to crank it up, but I still want a little bit of low end, what they do is they cheat. It's louder if I bring up the high and I save a lot of power doing it. They don't know the difference because they're drunk and I don't pound the crap out of my stuff. A little trick and tip for you guys when you're not running a real powerful system. So, and they want this stuff loud as hell. So, just saving on the equipment. There's a little trick for you. Might be a little bit too new for them. They're dancing. That's all that matters. Pretty easy night for me, really. Except for my back is sore as hell. Finally got a chair. And it's a little chilly and the mosquitoes suck ass. But otherwise, pretty simple. And then this makes it hard too.
This part, I believe that...
It's like 9:45. Supposedly there's a lot more people coming out later than their younger friends. So they have 15, yes, I said 15 half barrels of beer. That is by far the most beer I've ever seen at a wedding before. They came prepared to drink a lot. So, I know they've already burned through two of them. So we'll see what happens. Good scene right there.
It's a winner.
It's a winner. It's midnight. I still have 2 more hours to go. And I got an hour and a half to drive home through deer country, pretty much. They're all in the middle of nowhere. But that's what happens, so. But they're pretty drunk. I think we've gone through like 5 or 6 half barrels already. We'll see if more show up, I don't know. It is 20 after 12, and this is what it looks like in here. Yeah. A few people left to go to the bar. There's a few people in the other building eating. The bride is completely passed out, laying on the groom's lap. And I got 2 people sitting there, 3 people sitting there talking. Fan-freaking-tastic. Oh well, that's what happens sometimes. I'll probably close it out after this. Whew. All right guys, it's just a little tiny bit after 1 o'clock and I'm tore down, I'm on my way home. I went in to talk to the bride at like 12:15. No one was there, as you saw. She was passed out on her new husband's lap. A bunch of people had left, and then the whole wedding party left in the bus, and it was me and the parents, and they're like, well, we want to get out of here, so just leave. They didn't say it like that, but you know, whatever. So, cool. It was a good night. It was a pretty easy show for me. Sucks that I was so far away. Now I got an hour and a half of driving and in the middle of nowhere, but oh well. So anyways, thanks for tuning in, folks. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So thanks for tuning in. Practice and enjoy. And we will see you in another future episode.